Hey guys, welcome to Will's Workshop. Today we will be making a GoPro mount for the 3D printer. This will allow me to make good time-lapse videos as I make things. Stay tuned as I walk you through the process of measuring the camera and the printer out where I want to mount it, designing it in CAD, and finally printing it.
Alright, so here I am measuring out the physical dimensions of the camera. One thing to remember is that you do need to put where the shutter button is and where the USB port is so that you can activate the shutter and then obviously plug it in for a long shoot. Now for the tabs for the mount, they don't have to be too perfect because I'm not going to be using the GoPro mount at all, I'm just using my own. So as long as there's enough clearance, it'll fit and work. Now here I am measuring out the build plate on the printer. I already had that, had those dimensions taken. Now throwing in CAD, I am building up the stand right now, piece by piece. That is the through hole for the screw, and I'm just extruding it to the width of the stand, of the tabs. And now I'm adding some feet that will go between the heat bed and the aluminum, and underneath the aluminum sheet. I'll just add some fillets to it. It's about an eighth of an inch between those 2 feet. A little bit more than that, that's how big the aluminum sheet is. And now I'm just cutting out those slots for the camera mount, for the camera case to be able to mount into there. And then next, what I'm going to do is make the hexagon shape for the nut to fit in, and I went ahead and made it a little bit bigger than the nut is, just to make sure that it would stay. I wanted to give it enough clearance to fit. I ended up giving it a little bit too much, but it still works fine. And now we're done. Now for the case itself for the camera, basically just make a couple of rectangles one side the other and then extrude it out. The inside being just a little bit bigger than the camera body. Now I'm going to make the hole for the USB plug. You want to make this a lot bigger than the USB port itself, because the cable a lot of times has a body around it. That adds some extra thickness. Then here I'm making a couple slots for a tab that will help hold the GoPro into the body. Then there's the hole for the shutter release. This you want to make it big enough for your finger to go through. And then I just chamfered it, just to make it a little bit easier. And this is the front of the case. This is basically to bring the body in a little bit to prevent the GoPro from falling out too far, or from falling out in front of it. And here I'm just adding a little foot for that tab. And that's gonna keep the camera in place. And then now this is the two tabs that will fit into the slots on the stand. Basically it's 0.55 inches wide. That's the diameter of the top there. And then the clearance hole was about 0.235 inches. That gives enough room for the screw to go through. Now we just gotta load it up into Cura to slice it, reposition it how I want it to be printed. This way allows me to print it without any support structure. I like to build it on a raft. I've noticed it helps adhere to the bed. And as you can see, how it currently is the GoPro is just mounted onto a tripod, and the object that is being printed is just moving all over the place and doesn't make for a very clear time lapse of it actually building. It's just all over the place and kind of chaotic. Now with the GoPro stand being mounted straight onto the bed, it will move with the bed and obviously with the object, so the object will stay the same in the frame. and I think that will make for a much cleaner looking time lapse.
Alright, the print's done. Let's get off the bed and use some Velcro to attach it.
Now we just have to peel off all the support material. Put it on. All right, so I want to make sure that it will clear the frame of the printer as the bed moves. Looks pretty good. So now I will simply take a couple pieces of Velcro and attach them. Just like so. That way, to take this off, just peel this one off and slide it on. Alright, so I got the mount on the printer and the GoPro inside. I'm currently printing something, as you can see, and I'm recording the time lapse, so we'll see how it turns out. Alright, so as you can see, the Christmas tree ornament that I'm printing out is staying the same in the frame, and this allows you to clearly see it being built up layer by layer. If you like this video, click like and make sure you hit subscribe, and leave a comment below. Stay tuned to the next video.